We are at the M-1 Crane Creek project. This is a St. John's River Water Management District project being partly funded by the Save Our Indian River Lagoon program. The M-1 Crane Creek starts on the east side of I-95, runs parallel on the north side of 192, and drains into Crane Creek before flowing into the Indian River Lagoon. This project is good for the lagoon because it's taking all of that excess nutrient pollution flowing in from this very commercialized watershed area, from going into the lagoon, polishing it up, and cleaning it before it flows into the St. John's River.
So there's a natural ridge between the St. John's River and the Indian River Lagoon, about 2.5 miles from the Indian River Lagoon. So any water, any rainfall and runoff on the west side of that ridge would naturally go to the St. John's River, and any rainfall and runoff to the east of that ridge would go to the Indian River Lagoon. But about 100 years ago, the M-1 Canal was dug through that ridge, and it drained about 5,300 acres of land from the St. John's River into the Indian River Lagoon. So the point of this project is to restore that watershed. We're gonna do this and we're gonna put a weir in, or an operable structure, and that structure will hold back enough water, and we need that so on the west end of this same canal, we have a pump station that we're building right now. And that pump station will take the water from the canal and pump it through a big 24-inch pipe that's under I-95 and under the St. John's Heritage Parkway into a stormwater pond west of the Heritage Parkway. And from there, the water will be cleaned into a second pump station. And that second pump station will bring the water down the Heritage Parkway, along 192, and ultimately into the St. John's River, restoring the watersheds. So this project helps the lagoon by removing the harmful nutrients that end up in the Indian River Lagoon. About 3,100 pounds of total phosphorus and 24,000 pounds of nitrogen every year end up in the lagoon with that additional fresh water that was never supposed to go to the lagoon. It also has the added benefit of providing 7 million gallons per day for water supply in the St. John's River.
This project is supported by the St. John's River Water Management District, 2 Florida Department of Environmental Protection grants, and the Brevard County Save Our Indian River Lagoon Project Fund.
So this project is rediverting a lot of the stormwater and base flow, but homeowners can actually help out by rediverting some of that in their own homes. So making sure your downspouts are pointed into your grass instead of down your driveway, making sure all your sprinklers are pointed into your lawn, not irrigating the streets and your driveway. And setting things like irrigation timers can all reduce the flow of water that ends up in that stormwater and can help the Indian River Lagoon. If you want to learn more of these tips on how to reduce your own personal pollution, you can visit lagoonloyal.com, and the website gives you all sorts of things you can do in your own home.